So in this video, I will show you step by step how to set up TradingView for the POWERX strategy. So let's get started. All right, so here's how to set up TradingView for the POWERX strategy in 8 simple steps. So first of all you need to do is go to tradingview.com. That is step number one. Now, I recommend that you register for TradingView, even if you go for the free version, because this way you can get all the features that I'm showing you here in this video. You might even consider upgrading to the pro version, and the pro version is $14.95 per month. That is the version that I have, and I think it is well worth the price. So the first thing that you need to do is bring up tradingview.com and register for it. So let's already move on to step number two out of the 8 steps that I have for you. So step number two, you want to click on full featured chart. You see this is right here. And when you click on full featured chart, this is what it comes up. Since I'm logged in, the charts that I use is coming up. So I want to show you what will come up for you, which will be a new chart layout. So when you bring it up for the very first time, this here is exactly what the chart will look like. Step number three, you see, it's super easy. So step number three, here's what I want to do. Delete the volume. You see the volume information here on the bottom. I don't use volume. So in order to have a clean chart, I get rid of the volume because you see, it's kind of in the way of the prices right here. So in order to do this, on the upper left-hand corner, you see volume, you click on X, and this is how it disappears. So now it is already much cleaner, and that's what I like to do. So this is how easy it is. So let's move on. Let's go to step number four. This is where we want to add the indicators right now that I personally use in my trading. So the first indicator that I like to use is the RSI. Here's how you add indicators to TradingView. On the top here, you see an F. This is for function, right? You see Disney or the Dow, whatever you picked here, and then you see the F. That's what you want to click on. And then on the left, you look for RSI. This is the relative strength index. And you see it shows a built-in here. You just click on the relative strength index and it appears right on the chart. So let's close this here. Here's what I want you to do next. Where you see the RSI 14, I want you to click on this little settings icon. And when you do, we have to adjust a few settings here. So the first thing that you want to do is change the setting from 14 to 7 because I'm using a 7-day RSI. Now, under style, I like to change a few things. You see it is purple here right now. I like to actually change this. I leave it in purple, but I make the line a little bit stronger. See, it's a little bit easier for me to read this way. And the upper band, I'm setting to 100. And the lower band, I'm setting to 50. And the background, I like to set it to green. So I'm using green here with an opacity of 20. So here's what it does. When I click OK right now, see, this is what the RSI looks like right now. And as you know, the indicators that I like to use, RSI, I want to see that it is above 50 in order for me to get a buy signal. When it is below 50, it is a sell signal. So this is one of the three indicators that I like to use. The second indicator is the stochastics. So let's move on to step number five, adding the stochastics. So very simple here again. You click on the F, you just type in here stochastics, you bring it up, and same deal as with the RSI. We want to configure it a little bit here. On the stochastics, you click on the settings symbol, which brings up the settings here. So let's go to the inputs first. So the inputs we leave at 14, 3, and 3. And here's a few things that I do regarding the style. First of all, I don't need percent K, I only need percent D. So I get rid of percent K. For the percent D, I like to have this in red, actually. And the line strength, I like to have it in 3. So same here, upper band, I'm changing this to 100 and the lower band to 50. So upper band, 100, lower band, 50. Very similar to the RSI. See, it's super easy. And the background, I personally prefer green with an opacity of 20. So exactly the same thing here, and hit OK. As you can see, we're getting close to what I usually have. See, the first two look already very, very similar. This is what we did here. These are my original settings. Let's move on to step number 6. Add the MACD. Very similar here again. You click on the F, and now we are looking for the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence. That's what we are looking for. And again, we adjust the settings here. I simply click on this little settings symbol right here, and this brings up the MACD, and I'm coming back to you on the screen that we can do this together. So here's what I like to do. I don't use the histogram. I get rid of the histogram here. The MACD, I personally prefer to have it purple and a little bit thicker here. And the signal line, I like to have orange and also a little bit thicker. There we go. Precision, I leave on default, and that's pretty much it. So there you go. Now we have the three indicators. You see, they take up a lot of room here, so you can move these indicators around, make the panes a little bit smaller so that you can arrange any way you want. Okay, so there you go. There you have the three indicators. And as you can see here are my original chart settings, and here is what we just did. So is this helpful thus far? We will move on to step number 7 and 8. So we only have 2 steps left. But if this is helpful thus far, do me a favor, click on like, because this way I know which videos you like best and I will make more of them. And if this is your first time that you're on this channel and you think, wow, this is pretty cool, make sure that you hit subscribe and also the little notification bell, because this way you get notified whenever I release a new video. So let's move on to step number 7. This is where you add the Rockwell POWERX bars. See, this is one of the things I like to color my bars red when I see that all the three indicators are giving me a sell signal. And I like to color them green whenever I see that all the three indicators are giving me a buy signal. So I have created a little library, and here's how you add the library. So this is step number 7. You click on the function here and then you search for Rockwell. Okay, so when you do, you search for Rockwell and it should come up under Rockwell Trading POWERX bar coloring. Again, this is not official and we'll talk about this, what it means. You simply bring this up here, and when you do, you see right here you have actually the bars in the right colors. Now, here's what I like to do, and this is where we go to step number 8 now, which is the final step. I want to make sure that I see the bars and not the line. So I right mouse click here, click on settings, and I decrease the setting for the line here to 1. Okay, so there you have it. These are the 8 steps, and here is a lifesaver. You want to save this template here. So you want to make sure that you're saving this template here. You rename it to whatever you want. You can rename this to Rockwell POWERX strategy. Okay, you save it, because this way you have it available under templates whenever you need it. See, you can then simply load the chart layout. So whenever you messed it up, you don't have to do all of this over. Okay. So let me come back to you, because there's a few more important things that I want to mention. So this is everything that I describe in the book, The POWERX Strategy, on TradingView here. Now, keep in mind, there's a huge difference between TradingView and the software that I personally use, POWERX Optimizer, because here's what it is. On TradingView right now, you see, okay, when you should enter and when you should exit, right? But this is where on POWERX Optimizer, it actually shows you exactly how this stock would have performed over the past year if you had applied this strategy to the stocks, if you had traded the stock according to the POWERX strategy for the past year. It is filtering out all the stocks that show, give you a new buy signal or a new sell signal, because here's what you want to do. You only want to take the first buy signal or the first sell signal. So don't enter into a trade when the trend is already gone. So there are some major differences. Please make sure, this is just a quick setting so that you see very quickly, is it more likely to go up or is the stock more likely to go down? Anyhow, hope you find this helpful. If you did, do me a favor and give me a thumbs up. And also make sure that you subscribe to this channel, hit the little notification bell, because this way you get a notification whenever I release a new video. And right now I'm putting a few videos that you might find helpful right here on the screen. Simply click on any of the videos and hope that you enjoy it, and I'll see you in the next video.